WNBA action. Brian, how do you think this season will be remembered with the bubble and everything going on?
Well, some might say this season is even tougher than other seasons. No fans, health and safety restrictions, just unprecedented playing conditions. So I think this year's champion will certainly still have its worthy place in WNBA history.
Now here's Carter. On the wing, Courtney Williams. Off target from outside. Outside Wheeler. Fires from deep. Another three for the Sparks.
Well, Wheeler's three ball has come a long way. And her improvement also helps her team's spacing.
Right side Sims. Three-pointer. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kennedy Carter.
Some quick retaliation right there, huh, guys?
Yeah, sure didn't take him long to go and get those 3 points back.
Connects from three-point range.
A mature and really methodical scorer. Tolliver has a developed and dangerous jumper.
Carter. Good for the basket, starting off one for one with that shot. Outside Wheeler. The three is up. Good on the triple.
Straight makes out of the gate. That's just a nice start.
And in the first, little over a minute and a half in, it's stolen by Oguike. Watches the three, and the Sparks, another three.
Another basket here, and they've really come out of the gates fast here in the first quarter.
An 8-point differential.
As good as Nneka Ogumike is on the court, she's such an important inspiration to young girls, young fans everywhere off the court. As president of the WNBA Players Union, Nneka has done a phenomenal job representing her peers.
Here's Hawkins, and again, Atlanta with the triple.
Early on, nearly perfect from the floor. Just one miss on their first five shots.
Three from Kristen Tolliver. Good. And it's Atlanta the other way. Along with her sister Shanae, who is vice president, Nneka negotiated a new CBA before the 2020 season.
It really was a groundbreaking agreement, guys, giving more power to the players, be it compensation, player movement, child care. What a job Nneka did in leading the incredible athletes of this league.
Brings it from beyond the arc.
I think she owes the three-pointer dinner. It's been her best friend today, no question.
Well, it has been today anyway. I mean, look, most of her points have been courtesy of the deep ball.
Amanda Zawidi with the block.
Well, given Zawidi's unique size and length, I think she can be a dominant shot blocker in this league for years to come.
That's a dozen straight points coming off of threes.
Yeah, they're having free reign from beyond the arc. The defense is, I'm going to go out on a limb and say it, non-existent.
Atlanta calls timeout.
And guys, after being selected first overall in the 2014 WNBA draft, Shanae Ogumike had an explosive first season. She averaged over 15 points and 8 rebounds per game on her way to becoming an all-star and the league's rookie of the year.
Here's Parker. The three again can't hit. The Sparks with the lead. To the wing on the left. Again, the Sparks with the two. After a special rookie campaign, Tim, how has Shanae Ogumike continued to develop?
Well, since that special season, she has missed 2 full years because of really devastating injuries. But Shanae has not stopped competing and playing hard. Her list of moves continues to grow. Her feel for the game is so really advanced. She has great touch. An all-star in 2018. I think Ogumike's best basketball is ahead of her. The second-round pick back in 2012, since entering the league out of Connecticut, Tiffany Hayes has been one of the most reliable players in this league. In each of her first 7 seasons in the WNBA, Hayes saw her scoring increase. It culminated in 2018 when Hayes averaged over 17 points per game and was named to the All-WNBA first team.
Here's Cooper. Coffee. She hangs in there and dashes in on the second chance point.
Way to work the glass, buffet style. Everyone grab a plate. Second chance buckets, they can make a big difference.
The dream trail. And with Hayes, her coaches and teammates don't just love her for her scoring. There's a lot more to love.
Yeah, her toughness certainly garners respect from her teammates. In 2019, Hayes played through an ankle injury for a lot of the season. And beyond the offensive numbers, Hayes is known for her active defense on the perimeter.
Now here is Sims. Outside Hayes. Sweet little floater.
With a strong understanding of which shot to use in which scenario, a strong offensive presence is only a part of Hayes' game.
And that one's good. Cooper.
They're really struggling defensively. Too many easy buckets. I mean, what was the coach's game plan?
Who knows? And that's a really embarrassing performance defensively. And the coaching staff can't be happy.
And this is our first free throw of the game.
The versatility of Sims is what stands out the most. She's a fantastic guard, and it's a reason why she's such an important player for this team.
And the Sparks, another three! The D has gotten a little lax defending the three-point shot at that end.
Yeah, 3 of the last 5 baskets they've allowed coming from beyond the arc.
And they pick up 2.
A notable finisher around the rim. Sims doesn't want any weak spots in her game, and I admire that.
Sinks the triple.
They are doing some damage from downtown, guys.
Which is the main reason they're sitting on this huge early lead. What shooting?
Just an aerial display from beyond the arc. First quarter concludes, and a double-digit lead on the scoreboard. Sparks ahead, leading by 10. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. A lopsided first quarter in the books as we get ready to begin the second quarter. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from the Sparks. Guys?
It's simple. Not much has gone wrong to them offensively.
Very few bumps in the road, as it's been an easy ride for them.
Here's Cooper. She's covered by Sims. Cooper misses. Now here is Hayes. She's guarded by Sykes. And that one's good. Hayes
can carry the load or serve as a compliment to others. It's Hayes' versatility that I rank among the league's best.
And here we go, the dream on the fast break. Goes to the reverse layup and drops it in. And the record for most WNBA Defensive Player of the Year awards is 5. 5 of them. Guys, which current WNBA player could you see top that?
Well, I'd say Sophia Fowles, Blake. She's already won the award a few times. And if she can continue with this high level of defensive production, she could absolutely win a few more.
Yeah, solid choice, Tim, but I'm going to say Brittany Griner. She's already won the award a couple times, and she's constantly hosting block parties on the court. It won't be easy, but she has a shot.
Timeout call to Sparks.
But Odyssey Sims made it to her first WNBA Finals in 2017. Unfortunately for her, the Sparks, unfortunately, fell short of their ultimate goal. She battled to the very end with her team. They ended up losing to the Lynx in 5. We'll be right back.
on here in the second quarter. And despite not winning the championship in 2017, what do you think Sims may have learned from losing in the finals?
Well, I think it gives you a healthy perspective, Blake. You realize just how tough it is to win it all. You have to reflect on the good and the bad, though, and continue to turn your weaknesses into strengths. It probably motivated her to work even harder because she doesn't want to miss her shot at redemption.
Here's Sykes. Out of bounds, it'll go to the three. Second quarter of basketball, just over 1.5 minutes played so far. Kennedy Carter, she's open, and there's another one for the three.
A nice run they put together here to bring it close.
They really got hot, and I didn't think I'd be saying this a little while ago, but now it's anyone's ball game.
And the whistle blows, it's gonna be on Sykes. That's foul number two for her. And so here's Atlanta. They've only given up 2 points this quarter.
Carter, that's good.
They're going on a nice little run here.
And getting to the rack has been the key. They're getting point-blank looks time and time again.
The Sparks call timeout.
Yeah, I think the head coach saw too many easy buckets coming from inside and wanted to put a stop to it.
I would think so. If they keep giving up the kind of easy looks inside and that they have been, they're in big trouble, Tim.
And they've got to change something up. Let's see what they do.
Now played in this second quarter. A three for Kristy Tolliver. Again, the miss by the Sparks. Courtney Williams for three. It's hauled in by the Sparks. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. Here's Tolliver. And that one off the back of the rim and in.
This is just unselfish basketball at its finest. You just know that Sykes' teammates appreciate her willingness to share the wealth.
Count it.
This has been a great job of getting into the middle of that defense and scoring from the paint.
You know, really, that's why they're on this run. Get that close to the hoop, and it's a lot easier to drop shots.
Yeah, I love the way Tolliver shoots the rock. You know, the long ball is her specialty, and she's not afraid to let it loose.
Pass to Williams. Yes, and it's Courtney Williams with the assist that time.
Nice pass there to set up the bucket.
And 10 of their last 12 points have come off assists.
Here's Wheeler. Off target from three-point range. And the foul on Sawadee. That's her first foul. The Dream making a switch here. Atlanta trailing here.
That's her second foul, and the last thing she wants to do is pick up a third foul here because it's just way too early in the game for that.
And she's got her first free throws of the night right here.
The fourth overall pick of the 2020 WNBA draft, Kennedy Carter is an electric scorer, averaging more than 20 points per game in each of her 3 years of college.
One item that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it's tough to defend.
I don't think hustle is really ever in question with Hayes because her energy is pretty much always full of charge.
Well, guys, for her size, Courtney Williams is an outstanding rebounder. She's listed at 5'8", but she seems to play a lot bigger than that. I'm just so impressed with her grit and toughness on the boards.
Defenders can't stay so soft on the perimeter.
And it's Wheeler with the foul. That's her third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the line to shoot two. And this is her second trip to the free throw line. First free throw is good.
She didn't have a single free throw in the first quarter, but she started to play with a little bit more edge to her game here in the second.
The Dream making a switch here. The Sparks leading. three from Kristen Tolliver. Good for another basket. Put up 10 shots and made 7 of them.
They're getting their points now almost exclusively from 3-point range. 4 of the last 5 makes from beyond the arc.
And the defense practically giving them those shots.
And they'll take them.
From past the arc, they get the rebound. He can't get it to go. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Tipped away. And here we go, the dream on the fast break. And the basket by Parker.
What vision from Carter, able to survey the court, find the open player. Clock's on their side here.
That's right, they can hold it for the last shot.
Three, Nico Lumake. And the foul on Zawi B. So that'll be your second foul of the game. We're in the bonus. We'll go to the line to shoot 2. And so here's Atlanta, trailing by 2. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Lumake. That's her first foul of the game. We're in the bonus, and they'll go to the line. This is her third trip to the free throw line. Good on the second free throw. Carter misses. Now the Sparks moving it up for 3. hard that time. On Courtney Williams. Very hard to stop a Puma Cage. She gets to the line a lot, and when she gets there, she's a 75% shooter.
And good on the second, so she makes both.
And so here's Atlanta. It's a 10-point game. Williams,
beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now. I mean, there's more holes in their defense than in a block of Swiss cheese.
Man, this made me hungry, but that's right. Five of their last six makes were in tight. They've established themselves inside. Where's the chance? Her assist average has increased each year in the league. Williams has become a more willing passer. Great buy.
Here's Wheeler. Drills it from outside.
Think about a halftime smoking hot from beyond the arc.
Yeah, and as hot as they are from out there, there's absolutely no reason not to just keep letting them fly.
I agree, Brian. We should all have the green light.
And it's Ogumake missing.
On an open look like that, she's just got a gift for making the weak coverage pay.
That's a surprising miss. She's almost always deadly when she's that open, even from way downtown.
That's their third straight make off an assist, and it's always good when you can score points by getting teammates involved.
Yeah, that's a great ball.
The Sparks call timeout.
And after being drafted second overall in the 2014 WNBA draft, Odyssey Sims wasted no time getting acclimated to this league. In her first year, she averaged over 16 points per game and dished out over 4 assists per game. And at the end of the season, she was named to the WNBA's All-Rookie Team.
Outside Wheeler, from beyond the arc. And it's Courtney Williams with the rebound. Yeah, you watch her, and you see her mechanics are totally out of whack right now. She's lost all feel for her shot.
Yeah, and it's not hard to tell. You just look at the numbers right now. Nothing is going down for her.
Picks the three. They recover it. Here's Sykes. Cans the 12-footer.
Using her imaginative offensive mind, Sykes creates different ways to beat shot contests.
And despite a stellar rookie campaign, Odyssey Sims didn't play in her first All-Star game until 2019.
You know, that can happen sometimes, Blake. Had to play for a few different teams, but her expansive skill set and tenacious work ethic have always been there. Her All-Star nod symbolized her ability to turn potential into major production.
Here's Hayes. He's got 10. Here's Parker. It's rebounded by Vadiva.
And she doesn't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions.
And that one's good. Cooper.
Have to admire just how selfless Erica Wheeler is. She loves finding her teammates in their sweet spots.
Williams with it. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. And she gets it to go.
So far, going for more of an inside game here in the second half.
Sparks with the lead. Erica Wheeler drives in. And she drops in the layup off the glass.
Yeah, she's played an important role in her offense today. And really, without her, they might not have the lead right now.
7-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Outside Williams.
You know, it's just terrific positioning on her part to get the rebound. So, you know, she might not have the size or the height, but she's got plenty of smarts.
So skilled offensively. Not only does Wheeler create for others, she creates for herself.
2-on-9, no one back to stop it. Here's Vadiva. Off target. And here at the end of the third quarter, it's a double-digit ball game. Sparks ahead. They lead by 11. Don't go anywhere. The final quarter is coming up next on 2K Sports. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
Sliced the deep wide open with this feed. They really had no chance to prevent this basket.
Yeah, it was a great read of the defensive setup and also wonderful anticipation of the movement of her teammates before the pass.
And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know.
Inside, Billings. That falls.
Nice feed that time from Kennedy Carter.
The deeper we get into this game, the more offense we're seeing.
Yeah, both of these teams are firing on all cylinders right now. I love it. This defense is giving their shooters free rein to operate from beyond the arc.
And when you allow shooters to get going, then you're in trouble because they can hit even when they're well defended.
Parker's shot is off. They have a really solid lead at this point.
Definitely on the other side, really not much resistance put up.
Bangs home the trifecta.
They just continue to splash those threes. Eliminating the deep shot has to become priority number one for this defense.
Absolutely, Brian. You can't keep giving up that many points behind the arc.
I know she's doing her best to carry them, but she can only do so much. Things would be different for them if she was getting a little more help.
Ogumake can't hit.
Well, they're winning despite her errant shooting.
Strickland outside.
And a dream, another three.
Gotta be decisive in catch-and-shoot situations. And Strickland gave her defender no time for a shot contest.
Here's Wheeler. And she can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. To the middle. Carter, that's good.
And how huge has she been to give her team a lift?
Yeah, certainly their deficit would be a lot bigger if it wasn't for her efficiency at the offensive end of the floor.
Oliver, that's good.
She's really pummeled these defenders today, no matter who has been on her.
Atlanta calls timeout. Oliver with a strong contribution so far in this one.
She's been gunning from deep. If you're guarding her, you gotta get into her jersey. You can't sag off her at all, or you're just asking her to drop another three on you.
Here's Hawkins. It's stolen by Neko Ogumake. Pass to Zawi B. Ogumake.
Player, Ogumake has a great feel for which shot she can make.
To the inside. A beautiful reverse layup.
There's a pattern taking shape. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Yeah, four of their last five baskets have been of exactly that variety.
Wheeler can't get it to go. The dream on offense. They trail by 11. It's Hayes missing.
Terrific job defending the basket that time. It's not an easy task stopping her when she's headed to the rim.
Pass to Wheeler. Back to Tolliver. From downtown. Here's Ogumake. Nice work on the boards. Paying off with the basket.
When your star also does the dirty work like Ogumake, it sets a tone for the rest of the team.
And on the Sims, here we go. And a block shot turns into a shooting foul. Oh, the defensive effort there. A bit too much as the officials are centered on the line. And the dream making a change here. And so she hits both. Timeout called the Sparks.
Carter.
Yes, great play by Odyssey.
pick up the pace and pick it up fast.
Took him no time at all on that one.
What makes Zawi be special is her ability to operate all over the court, mid-range included.
And Williams gets it to go.
She's having one of those days where she takes it, she makes it.
Consistent shooter to land the much-needed basket.
Oliver, no good.
Wow, man, this quarter has been ugly for her.
And it's not showing signs of turning around anytime soon. Her touch is all but gone.
Every team needs a player who can deliver in crunch time, and Sims shows she can handle that work.
Oliver, no good.
This has been a rough second half for her shooting the ball. She should probably adopt a mentality at this point. Big, in big moments, Williams' domination and handles and shooting ability make her a tremendous option for late games.
Lays it from downtown! You want Tolliver in these kinds of situations because she's poised under pressure and really can be a go-to scorer in the clutch.
Atlanta calls timeout. Yeah, what's your take, guys?
They got two options. Take the three to tie
it,
or get a quick
two to foul. And if it moves up to the inside, it wouldn't be a bad call. But the foul has to come immediately after.
It has to have to come immediately. You cannot waste a second.
Count it! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
Check out the vision from Hopkins. That kind of unselfishness will give her team a spark offensively.
Yeah, they had to do that. You just can't let them dribble it out.
Definitely. Gotta stop the clock.